Tens of thousands of women are having to fend for themselves, the casualties of war, famine, and HIV/AIDS. But instead of being defeated by hardship, many are being inspired by opportunity. Like Alistair Shimin. When we first met her a few years back, she barely survived on what little she could grow.
I had no job, so I was jobless. I had not any income to sustain my life and for my children. And I was facing so many problems.
Her teenage daughter desperately wanted to go to school, but there just weren't the funds. Now Alice is a qualified tailor with skills that have got her back on her feet. What's more, she's sending all of her kids to school, and now passing on her tailoring talents to others.
When you are a tailor and have you know how to design all fashions according to the to your country, you can get market. And in this, I've learned how to sew the African wear. That's the bitenge. You sew bitenge and then put on the other thing on the head like a Nigerian.
For £50 a month, women can go on this short training course. That may not sound like much, but it's beyond the means of most, many of whom are widowed or on their own. But once they have the skills, they can expect to earn up to £100 a month if they're motivated to set up their own business. What we do at the WOMA Trust is to help them get there.
Whatever little I get, I save the half of it, and the other half of the profit, I use it for the daily, on the daily basis, or basis on food, then plus school fees for children, health issues, and then plus, you know, clothing, all the basic needs.
In many parts of Africa, it was once men who were the main breadwinners, but AIDS is now so rife that women are having to step into their shoes, taking on new jobs and starting up their own businesses. Many don't yet have the skills, but it needn't be that way. The WOMA Trust is committed to giving them practical help.
Oh, United!
United!
Everybody now, get the facts and get to know what AIDS is all about.
All these women have completed their WOMA training. We brought them together to exchange tips and show off the items they've made.
It's a kind of sharing. If you come across your friend and you tell her your the problems you are facing with the market, maybe she can direct you.
Each woman now has a sewing machine, their first piece of capital, and they're in business to survive.
I had lost hope in everything. But when I got that chance of joining Text, I said, wow, so God, hear prayers. So now, I can earn something. I was really so happy, all out from up country, to come here in Kampala.
United!
Women are increasingly bearing the brunt of Africa's woes. They make up nearly half of the global HIV/AIDS epidemic, but with the prospect of new drugs comes fresh hope. Hope that with a bit of help, they can develop new skills and lead active working lives.